In our first story, the Church of Pentecost has built and donated a prison infrastructure to the Ghana Prison Service at Ijura in the Ashanti region. The fully furnished facility has three dormitory blocks with the capacity to accommodate 300 inmates. It has an administration block, a chapel which will also serve as a classroom, a football pitch, baptistry, modern washrooms, mechanized borehole, offices, infirmary, workshops, and other auxiliary facilities. It was jointly commissioned by the Interior Minister Ambrose Derry, Chairman of the Church of Pentecost Apostle Eric Nyamiche, and the Chief of Ijura, Berima Osei Shidie II. The Interior Minister said the Church of Pentecost has proven to be a first-class corporate citizen.
Unlike some of the prison facilities we have in Ghana, who are remnants or remains of the colonial era, this facility has been purposely built according to specifications with features like the workshop, multi-purpose workshop, which will facilitate reformation and rehabilitation of inmates. Even though society still upholds difference, retribution and other attributes of interest that characterize custodial sentences, the main interest and the premium for us, government, is namely seeing offenders reformed, rehabilitated, add value to their lives as they return to the society as law-abiding citizens. That is the emphasis for us. And in that, we have found no better partner than the Church of Pentecost, Ghana, to humanity. They are building five prison facilities, including this edifice in Nigeria and four others, which are at which is commendable. Three of the said facilities, I'm reliably informed, at an appreciable level. One of, as the Minister for Interior, I'm aware that other places in the country, interventions have been made with the police service, various facilities put in place. And this Vision 2023 shows a consistent, well-thought-out strategy where people's lives are going to be transformed and even startups be given to some to start. Please, the Church of Pentecost are proving to be a first-class corporate citizen.
Now, the General Secretary of the Church of Pentecost, Apostle Alexander Nanaya Kumilabi, has joined us via Zoom. Apostle, thanks for joining us. Tell us, what inspired the church to embark on this project?
Thank you and good morning. Thanks for having me. Yeah, I'm very grateful to God for this special honor than us to throw more light on our Vision 2023 agenda. The current chairman, Apostle Eric Nyamiche, when he was elected in 2018, he declared that the church now has the numbers and therefore we should let our presence be felt in the nations. So for the next 5 years, our overarching theme is possessing the nation. That is, we want the virtues that we learn at church to be reflected in the society. It's under these themes that we have rolled out some of the activities that seeks to let the church become relevant in the society. We have sub-themed that as transforming the society. So in COP, we think that it is time for the churches to, as it were, their presence be felt in the society, regards to the funds that comes to us, regards to character reformation and transformation of individuals' lives. So we decided that the way to go was to let the society feel the presence of God so that through that we'll be able to reach out to the unreached and unsaved in the society. So running on the back of this, we are putting up some structures to help the government or the developmental agenda of the government, which also falls in line with the vision of our church. So as the Honorable Minister rightly said, I will put out some police stations, and also we are put, one is a huge one is at Bumwafete, and then one was put out at Kwaponekwapim. And for the prison service, they approached us, and when they came, we realized that it fits rightly in our vision, because Chairman has been saying that for us Christians, sinners are our clients, and law offenders are our clients. So people who find themselves on the right, on the wrong side of the law, they are the people that we seek to help reform, rehabilitate, and then give them a sense of hope. So this is the first of the five that we are ruling out. If the law tarries, maybe in 3 months' time, the one in Psalm 2 will be commissioned. So this is what has informed us to do this for the nation.
Wow. Apostle, thank you very much. I mean, I'm sure you've heard so many appreciations from the public. Now, you said earlier that it was the Ghana Prison Service which approached you, and that is why you decided to embark on this project. But some would also ask that, I'm sure you've been approached by many organizations. Why settle on this particular request?
Thank you very much. As I said, we did one for the Ghana Police Service at Bumwafete, and then we started one at Ekopon, Ekwiapim. So when they approached, it fits into our vision. We were going to do it anyway, but thank God maybe they got wind of it and approached us. We thought that our prisons are too congested. At the time, the figures we were having was that it's almost 60% in excess. And we couldn't sit back seeing our fellow human beings, as it were, to be packed like sardines and not know, having space to, as it were, freedom. We know their freedom has been curtailed, but where they were laying their head, where they eat, and the environment we thought was going to make them even harder criminals than they went there. So yes, they did approach us, but it really fits into our vision. Therefore, we said, right, this opportunity that has been thrown at us, let's take, accept the challenge and move on. So we are doing a lot for the society. Let me humbly say that we are not rejecting ourselves, but we think the church ought to pay back to the society. So we are doing police stations, we are doing chief's compound, we are building, constructing boreholes, we are giving scholarships. We are doing a lot of things, but this is just one of the many things that the church intends to do in the next 5 years.
Amazing.
At least under our theme, Possessing the Nation Agenda, this is just one of the many things the Lord is leading us to do for our nation and other nations where the Church of Pentecost presence is felt.
Amazing. So from what I hear you say, you are not limiting your donations and your philanthropic works to Ghana. You would actually be extending your hand to other nations where the church is operating in.
Yeah, the accounts we say Ebumunse Pai is about the same thing. Rather, if you observe, our church is spread across over 109 nations. So wherever our presence is, wherever the church is, we are rolling out a program for the church leadership there also to do something. Yes, the headquarters is at Ghana. So we come up with a vision, we show them where we want to go, and we encourage and support them to do what we are doing in Ghana. So if you go across the nation, the globe, you'll be observing or you'll be hearing and seeing the things that the church is doing all over the place.
Now, we know, Apostle, that the Church of Pentecost often pays fines for persons who are in prison so that they are not given custodial sentences. After this massive project, which is continuing, will the church still be engaged in this kind of work?
Now, thank you very much. We're not going to stop whatever we've been doing. This is an add-on. And even with this, as we said, we're going to use the chapel for classrooms. Want to encourage them, those who can write the BEC and then WASC, and we are partnering with the university, Pentecost University, will partner with Ghana Prisons, and why not those who have the capacity to study to the tertiary level we are prepared to give them a helping hand. So yes, those we've been, as it were, pay their fines for them to release, that will continue. We've encouraged individuals, members in our church also to come on board. So periodically, yes, we'll go on to do those things. And once a while, too, when people are not able to pay their bills at the hospitals, we'll extend support to them and pay so that they can go home. The church is there to help society. Mm. The church is there to provide the needed relief. Mm. If Jesus was to be here, things that he would have done, he has left us, the church. We are little Jesuses and want to let people enjoy the grace and the benefits that we have enjoyed from our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. He came to seek and also to save those who are lost. So we're also prepared to go to the vulnerable and to help them. I've said to people that one quotation that challenges me is Matthew chapter 25, where on that D-Day, Christians will be separated into two blocks. The base, bottom line, how you use the resources that God bless you with. Did you use it on yourself or use it to serve the society? That's why you say, you ask, I was in prison, they didn't visit me. I was hungry, they didn't give me food. I felt cold, they didn't provide me with clothing. Yes, what did you do with your resources? So we as Christians and Church of Pentecost, we are prepared to share our limited resources with the weak, vulnerable, and the marginalized in the society.
And since you mentioned the scripture, what's your message to other church organizations, many of whom are criticized heavily by the public for not engaging in activities as the church is doing now?
Thank you, my brother. Let me quickly read the quotation that we have put up at Edura. Hebrews chapter 13 and verse 3 reads, and I quote, "Remember those who are in prison, as though in prison with them, and those who are mistreated, since you are also in the body." This is instructive. This is a command. So we Christians, we are encouraged to remember those who are in prison. And then when we find somebody mistreated, we should feel for the person and extend a helping hand to the person, because we are also in the body. It means you may fall, you may find yourself in such situations. So you shouldn't look down on people who are vulnerable, the destitute, and the marginalized. So fellow Christians in Ghana, we're over 70%. And I think it is time we got up for us to be counted as people who really read the Bible and understand. The church is not there for leaders to amass wealth. The church is supposed to be a conduit of blessing to the society. We gather the members, we preach the gospel to them, we encourage them to give. The monies that come into our coffers, leaders are not supposed to use it on themselves. They are supposed to use it to put up schools, to support the developmental agenda of the government and other institutions in the country. So yes, we extend a hand to our brothers and sisters in other religious organizations to come on board, help us together, as it were, fix the nation, so that together our presence will be felt, and therefore people will have hope in the Jesus that we profess to be following. So this will be my message for other Christians.
Apostle, thank you very much. Before you go, though, we just want to keep you on for just a few more minutes so you see the reactions that have come on social media on your donation. This is from Maupemo Kobla. He says, "The church has failed humanity, so they are now building prisons to accord their corrupt system." The church is supposed to reform society, and if the church is building a prison, it has failed totally. Why can't they build factories rather to save the unemployed? Well, Real Wise Brain says, "I am now convinced. I'll start giving offering when I go to Pentecost Church." Godwin Sekop says, "Well done." Kweku Rasta says, "Some of your congregants are in poverty. Don't build prisons." A number of questions on why there should be prisons. Kobi Asma says, "You use the offerings of the sufferings of the people and unemployed to build a prison for them instead of factories, schools, or even a vocational center to offer offer employment and hope for the hopeless in the Church of Pentecost and the country." His hashtag is "No More Offerings and Tithes." Ekufo Owusu says, "Proud of the Church of Pentecost." Thomas Kobi Gbeji says, "Good initiative. Zahaku Hafiz Shemtor says, anyway, why do you want to go there? Who do you want to go there? All right. Kofi Plaha says, church builds prisons and government builds cathedrals. How would you react to these comments, Apostle?
It's a bit interesting, though. Let me respond by saying, we have not failed humanity and Ghanaians. If I think history will bear us out that the various educational institutions that we have in this country were put about by Christian institutions, as it were. Jesus, when the woman broke the alabaster bottle on him, and Judas and others complained, Jesus said, the poor and the sick and the vulnerable will continue to be with us. Having said that, doesn't mean that we should not extend and help a hand to them. So far as these people continue to be around, that's why Matthew 25 is there. It means that when somebody finds him or herself on the wrong side of the law and is incarcerated, Jesus will ask us, when I went there, what did you do? We ask, when did we find you in prison? They said, people were there and you didn't do anything. So we're hiding behind that to do just that. And as Hebrews also commands us, we are supposed to remember them. So going to them doesn't mean we are failed. It's just a clarion call. It's just an awakening that has come to us that, hey, we can't continue to neglect these people. Coming home, we have a lot of scholarships in our church. And if you get a copy of the State of Church address recently read by our chairman during our council meeting last week, you bear me out. We are doing a lot. As I said, Pentecost, we don't want to always showcase what we do. So let me rest my case on that. But contact our various offices and know the various support we are giving to our numbers and members in relation to scholarships. And we have a lot of schools around, over 83 basic schools we have. And we have the Pentecost University there. And then we have also, as I said, we've been building and constructing a lot of boreholes in the countryside. We think we are contributing our widow's mite to the society. Right. So members of the church, come on board, support us, we'll never fail you. The monies you give to us, we know you have confidence in us. That's why you continue to give. And we'll also use it too for the development of our nations. So just continue praying with us and support us. It's unfortunate people think the church is building prisons, the government is putting up a cathedral. Whatever it is, we have responded to the call that God has given to us. We want to support the weak and the vulnerable. Let me quickly add, Elvis, you know this time around we've rolled a program, Ministry to Persons with Disabilities, and we are helping them. We are supporting them. We are sponsoring them. We're educating them. Yes, we pray for their healing, but as their healing delays, should they continue to be in pain? No, we have to encourage them to live a meaningful life. So this is all Christianity is about. Jesus came, he left the temple and visited Zacchaeus. He left the temple and visited Simon the leper. Bible says he was a leper and Jesus visited him. So yes, we visit them in prison. Doesn't mean we are failed. COP will never fail Ghana. COP will never fail our members.
Apostle Alexander Nanaya Kumilabi, thank you very much. And I believe the greeting is Christ in you.
Hope of glory. Hallelujah.
Have a good day. You're live on News Desk with me, Daniel Dazzi.